then let's see. In order to process the arrays, obviously we need some control statements. So this is the right place to discuss them. Let's see them. Okay. So we know if else conditions, we know switch case statements, we know the basic data types. Int float long double, string, and some string operations. Now arrays, and let's see the loop statements. And out of these loops, same like any other language, you see while, do while, and for loops. Okay. So while loops are pretty same. I don't need to run any example on this. I will just show you this, and I will leave up to you just to practice this. Okay. So I just have, if you see in this example code, I have an object, singleton object, object test. I have a main method inside this. So this is the basic fundamental stuff that is needed for execution, right? So as I was showing you in the Eclipse, so these are the two options. Either you declare an object, singleton object, that extends app, or a write an object, and inside that you should have a main method. This is very well same as the public static void main in Java. Okay, public static void main method in Java. So define main, args, and there also in Java we take the string array as arguments. Here also the arguments are string array. Okay, anyway, we'll discuss this portion in detail more once we start the hoops concepts. Okay, the two ways to make your application executable or launchable. Okay, so that's, those are the two ways. Now coming to the loops that we are talking about, I declared a variable a with initial value as 10, and while a less than 20, value of a plus a equal to a plus 1. This is a pretty simple while statement. You can run it. Okay. Do while, its concept is remains the same. It first executes that the block of code, and then it validates the condition. While statement, it first checks the condition and then executes the block of statement. But here, for the first time, it executes the block of code and then executes the condition. Do until a less than 20, while a less than 20. As long as a is less than 20, this block will get executed. Okay. Now, let me show you the for loops. Right. So in Java, we know the for loops, the different types of for loops. Okay. Let's say the very basic for loop that everyone know is that, let's say if I have int I there, declare I equal to 0, I less than 20, I plus plus or minus minus or whatever the condition that we do. Okay, I equal to I plus 1 or I plus 2, however you want. This is one basic for loop syntax in Java. Okay. And the other thing is, let's say if you have a names array, and if you want to go through each one of these elements, for loop, what we say, string name colon names. Now we'll go through, or I can say like this, until less than 5, parental and off. Okay. I can even very well write this in the same Java code that we have written there, and it can show you pretty well there instead of writing this interface. Okay. It's always better to show its equivalent Java code as well. Now, int I is already there. Let me use L then. L. Okay. Names of year, the same year, same is out. Different types of for loops I am trying to show you all at once. Okay. Now you have these two ways. Now coming to the Scala part, let's declare that array. I already have this in array. Now, so one thing, one type of for loop is, instead of that colon, we can take the range here. So arrow mark, you will see the left arrow, left side arrow. So A, 1 to 10 or 1 to 5. I 1 to 5 or 0 to, since we know it's 0 to 4, even though the size is 5. So println of names of I is the same functionality. Okay. Now, this is one way of writing your for loop, by specifying the range. And the next for loop type that we can specify for loop with collections or arrays. I can even simply specify the array name. Okay. Without specifying the range, I can just specify the array name and don't even need to worry about the data types of it. For A, it's names. Okay. Println of A. Okay, so even that is possible. Now, what else are there? Let me show you all the different types of for loops in once and then execute. Yeah. So this list specifying the collection on the right side of your arrow, or the range on right side of your arrow, same like your Unix for loops or Python for loops it looks like, right? If you are from Python background or so. Okay. So in case if you want to calculate the length or total value, all these things, you can traverse through this operations and you can find out them. So finding the largest element, I took the my list from my list of 0, the first element as max, and from 1 to my list dot length of minus 1, every time I'm checking with the max value, and I want you to try these examples. This is a working piece of code. Okay, let me show you. That is a plain same, the usage of specifying either the range or the collection on the right side of your arrow symbol. Now we have one more for loop variety with yield class as well. For loop with yield, this is especially for each iteration. If you are producing one result out of it, if you are, instead of simply processing it, so in this case, here I'm simply, in these for loops, I'm simply processing those elements and printing them. That's it. I'm not returning any result out of each of these. I'm not returning any element out of each of these iterations. Let's say I want to print all these names, but I want to make every name as uppercase. Okay? A dot to uppercase. I want to convert all your names into uppercase. Now, this is the last statement of my for loop, and this is the result of it, and this will get returned. Okay, now I can say, so generally I cannot collect this into a collection if I put this inside a loop. After processing each element, so do the set of, execute the set of statements that are present in the for loop. Also, yield the result a dot to uppercase into a collection where upper names type. So for each of these things, the for loop, if I have some operations and return the results, then I can do this. So inside this, I can have multi lines. Println of A. And then this. So here, any logic that you want to perform inside a for loop, yes, you perform that in the same block with yield, and the last statement that you return, the last statement in your, the for loop block, will be the result or the return of your each iteration, and that will be get captured into one another collection. So since we are dealing with an array here, so the data type of upper names also became another array, and it is going to contain all the uppercase values of this thing. See? Yes, Mamta, let me complete this. I will give you some space. Okay. Now, here we have seen with the range, we are able to print the names. We can see the outputs there. Okay. And after that, again, by giving the collection name, we print it. And here with this, I converted everything into two uppercase. The upper names, now you can see automatically collecting the result of this upper converted values. So to summarize, you have mainly three types of for loops till now. Okay, at least but now, as of now, you know three types of for loops. One, specifying the range of your index and process your list through that index. Second one, take that list directly on the right side and process each element. Don't worry about the index numbers here. Okay. Third one, an add-on to that, you can also use Yeild class, which can whose each iteration's result can be captured into another collection. Okay, and these two for loops, anyway, I don't need to explain this much. This you might be knowing already. Now, you can even run multiple for loops, I mean nested for loops as well, for loops with multiple counters, i122, j122. Generally in Java, nested for loops, how will we write? So inside this, let's say for or I will declare k equal to 0, k less than 5, k plus plus, just sys out until and all. i j r l comma k. Right. So now let me execute this. Oh, here I can't. I have to execute the complete Java code here, unlike the Scala interpreter. Yeah, array index out of bounds, somewhere I'm trying to Yeah, so my main intention is not about actual results, the for loops. Okay, zero, and I can even turn off these. Okay, so here you can see, so 0 0 0 1 0 2, so to traverse through the nested for loops you have to write this way, but whereas in Scala you can write the for loops the same for I 1 to 5 or j 1 to 5, println this way, just one line of. You can write, you can specify them. So whatever the expression that you specify first, that is taken as the outer for loop, and anything after that is taken as the nested for loop. Okay, you can even do up to multiple levels. You can see the same result kind of thing you're getting. Now I have the break statement and break statement example next.